Hello friends, welcome to the Diwali special edition of Culture Katha. Diwali is another of those great Indian festivals that offer different people different reasons to celebrate. In the north of India, Diwali signifies the return of the ideal King Ram to Ayodhya and the beginning of Ramarajya. In the south, it is the celebration of the end of evil that took the form of the wicked asura Naraka. The asura was eventually slain by Krishna. In the west, especially among the merchant communities, Diwali is an auspicious time to invite home Goddess Lakshmi, the giver of wealth and riches. In this video, we are going to try and understand a little more about Goddess Lakshmi, her symbolism and her iconography. Friends, right from the ancient times, Indians have always tried to give a human form to natural phenomena. For instance, the Vedic Indians imagine the morning dawn as a beautiful damsel named Ushas, the gushing river waters as Saraswati, or the dark night as Ratri. Lakshmi too is one such goddess who represents the qualities we all desperately seek: riches, well-being and prosperity. When we think Goddess Lakshmi, we visualize her in a red sari, sitting on a red lotus in a pool of water, with two elephants by her side showering water on her as she holds a kumbha or a pot. But what does this picture mean? How are they connected to the idea of the goddess? Is there some special significance to them? Let's find out. Goddess Lakshmi is closely associated with the waters. The earliest reference we have of the goddess is in the Sri Sukta, which is believed to be a later period addition to the Rig Veda. In the Sri Sukta, the goddess is referred to both as Sri as well as Lakshmi. And she is described using adjectives such as apa, which means water, and chiktilta, which means stickiness or the moisture that exists in all beings. So it appears that in the Vedas, she was seen as the goddess of the waters that make up life. The composer of the Sri Sukta invokes Lakshmi to ask for cattle, horses, progeny, beauty, food and servants. All these are of course possible only with the blessings of the goddess, who is an embodiment of the life-giving waters. Lakshmi's association with the waters continues into the later times too. In the story of the churning of the ocean that appears in the Mahabharata, Lakshmi or Shri is described as the daughter of the ocean and she arises from it. The Shri Suktam makes several references to Lakshmi's association with the lotus. The verses describe the goddess as residing in the lotus and as being born of the lotus. She is also the color of the lotus and has eyes and thighs of a lotus. The lotus, being a water flower, is naturally associated with her. For lotus, like the waters, is also a symbol of fertility and bounty. But the lotus is also associated with purity and transcendence. So even though the lotus grows in so much of muck and dirt, it's not affected by its surroundings. Lakshmi too is like that. The Sri Suktam mentions an elder sister to Lakshmi called Alakshmi, who brings wretchedness and ill luck to a person. Lakshmi drives away the ill fortune brought on by her elder sister and bestows well-being and prosperity to her devotee. Thus, like the beautiful lotus that grows in dirt, Lakshmi, despite being the younger sister of the terrible Alakshmi, is very different from her. Often, Lakshmi is shown holding a kumbha or a pot. The kumbha in Indian symbolism represents the womb. This emphasizes the idea of Shri or Lakshmi as the goddess of fertility. The Sri Suktam also makes an indirect reference to her as the earth by associating the goddess with fragrances and forbearance, which is nothing but patience. The reference to her as the earth is yet another connection of the goddess to fertility and abundance. So Shri or Lakshmi represents that magical property of the soil to produce vegetation. The idea of a fertility goddess is supported by archaeological evidences too. The earliest archaeological depictions of Lakshmi can be found in the Ashokan stupas of Sanchi and Bharhut from nearly 2500 years ago. In these relief structures, Lakshmi is shown having full breasts and wide hips, both of which are symbols of fertility and abundance. And thus, the water, lotus and kumbha complete the picture of Lakshmi as the goddess of prosperity and bounty, the one who can bestow all kinds of riches, including food, cattle, gold and progeny for her devotee. In the Bharhut and Sanchi depictions of Lakshmi, we find her being consecrated by two elephants on her either side, showering her with waters from a celestial pot. This depiction resembles a royal crowning ceremony where the king is anointed before he is crowned. The Sri Suktam too makes a reference to this idea when it says that her arrival, or Sri's arrival, is heralded by the sound of trumpeting elephants. Well, elephants have always been a symbol of royalty, and Lakshmi is associated with royalty because she represents wealth. The royal elephants hail and celebrate her because without the goddess of good luck and fortune, a king is powerless and his kingship useless. Thus, Lakshmi is not only sought after by the merchants and traders, but also by the kings and the governments. Friends, this Diwali, may the great goddess Shri smile on all of us, drive away the misfortune and ill luck that's been plaguing the world so far, and usher in well-being and prosperity for one and all. Till we meet again and start our bye-bye, take care and a very, very happy and safe Diwali to you all.